Welcome to DataBit Technologies. I am Shah, and this is part 5 of SQL Server video series. This is the part 5 of SQL Server. In this session, we'll understand what is cascading referential integrity constraint is. In part 3 of this video series, we have seen how to create tables and add primary and foreign key constraints. And in part 4 we have seen how to add a default constraint. We had created database name as sample, and tables person and gender. And we have marked gender ID column as a foreign key column within this person table. Let's suppose, if I ask, what is the gender of Jade? What will you do? You'll check the value of this gender ID column. Let's go to gender table. Check number 2 is female. So Jade's gender is female. Now let's suppose, if I delete this female record from gender table, Jade and May records will have no meaning. So if I ask you now, what is Jade and May's gender, there is corresponding record here, so not able to tell their gender. So these two records Jade and May will become orphan records. By default SQL Server doesn't allow these kinds of deletes. Let's go back to SQL Server Management Studio. And if you look at the sample data that we have within these two tables now. If you look at Sarah. The gender of Sarah is 2, which is female. Now let's see what happens if I delete this female record from gender table. In person table there are still rows referring that value. So when I try to delete, I get an error. Look at this, the delete statement conflicted with the reference constraint person gender FK. In part 3 of this video series we had created a foreign key constraint with this name person gender FK. So what is this constraint saying? If we expand this table. Tables and column specifications, so in person. In person, the gender ID column is referring to ID column in gender. So that's what we have said using this foreign key constraint. Okay, now if you scroll down a little bit in this foreign key relationships window. There is this insert and update specification. And by default if you look at the delete and update rule it is set to no action. So the default is no action. So if it is set to no action. And when you try to delete any of the existing rows for which there are references in person table. That kind of a delete will not be allowed by default. For specifying the cascading referential integrity. You have 4 options. The default is no action, in which case you get an error and the statement will be rolled back. You can also specify cascade. Set null. And set default first. Let's look at set default now if you remember in the previous session. We have seen how to set a default. Using a default constraint. So if you look at the constraint that we have already on person table. So it's called default and person on gender ID column and we specified that. If somebody doesn't supply a value for the gender ID column, then we want to use a default of 3. That's what this default constraint does. And if you're not sure how to set up a default constraint, I strongly recommend watching the previous session in this video series. Okay, now what you can do is. In this foreign key constraint window in insert and update specification section. If somebody tries to delete a row, I want to set it to a default. Click OK. And save the changes. Now if somebody tries to delete. If somebody tries to delete this female record from gender table. Any dependent rows must set it to default. And the default that we have here is there. So it's going to set that 2 to 3. Now let's try to delete this. And see what's going to happen. And we select the data back. You should see Sarah gender ID set to default, which is 3. And along the same lines, you have other options as well. You can either cascade the delete and update operation, or you can set to null. Let's see how set null works. Obviously, if you want to change the update and delete cascade operation, you have to come to the insert and update specification. In the delete rule, let's say I want to set null instead of set default. Close and save it. Now let's go ahead. Let's go back to the tables. So in person table, if you look at this, there are John and Rich. Their gender is male. Now let us say I want to delete this male record. So what did we specify in cascading referential integrity? Let's suppose, use set null. So when I delete this male record from this primary key table, the gender ID for the dependent rows will be set to null. So in this case, John and Rich rows will be set to null. So let's execute that. Now let's select the data back. So John and Rich gender ID is set to null. And the final option that we have is cascade. As the name suggests, we want to cascade the update and delete operation to the dependent table. How do we do that? Go into the foreign key constraint window and insert and update specification section. Instead of set null, we will say cascade. Close that. And save it. Now if you look at gender table, we have number 3 for unknown. And there are 3 people. Simons, Sarah and Johnny, whose gender ID is unknown. Now if I go ahead and delete this record from gender table, all the dependent rows will also be deleted from person table. So in this case, these 3 rows will be deleted. Okay, so go on. All those 3 rows are gone. So you know there are 4 options available for you when setting up cascading referential integrity constraint. The default is no action. If you set this option by default, you get an error and the update and delete statements will be rolled back. Otherwise you can cascade the updates and deletes. Or you can set null. The dependent rows can be set to null or they can be set to defaults. That's all for today. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day. Having success in your work.